23MBH Jayco Whitehawk here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Nice lightweight unit with a big living room slide, a couple bunks in the back, and both a front living room and front bedroom, but more on that when we get inside. Whitehawk is really the next generation after Jayfeather. Though the Jayfeathers are still around, the Whitehawks have become Jayco's primary lightweight unit. A lot of the same construction goes into these, and what's kind of interesting is a lot of the same construction goes into every Jayco. That's why they have twice the warranty of basically anything else in their class. And that's one of the things I like to talk about, is why do they have double that warranty? Why do they have double the assurance for their customers? That's kind of what I'm going to poke at here in this video. Things like, when you look at things like power awnings and power tongue jacks and lightweight units, it's like candy anymore. It's like everyone's giving these things away. But Jayco gives you a little bit higher grade of power tongue jack, and like your awning motor, your power awning, your power tongue jack, they move faster, they last longer, they don't have to over torque themselves to work. Stuff like that means more reliability, more longevity. Now, construction's a huge difference in a Jayco compared to most anything else in a lightweight class, and that's pretty true of Jayco in general. Their construction's usually far and away better. They are fully vacuum laminated. Now, a lot of lightweight trailers, you can come thump on the sidewall, but you can't thump on the front or rear walls like you can on a Jayco. Walk up to the sidewalls of a slide out if you want to kind of get a feel for how another one's built. It's fully laminated. That also means it's fully insulated. Very few lightweight trailers insulate slides very well. That's a nice thing on these Whitehawks, is they will hold their cabin temperature better both in summer and winter. Frameless windows are standard here. You're not paying extra for those. I like that they're standard because that means the guy at the factory is installing the same thing, the same way, every single time. He doesn't have to install window A one time, window B the next. Stuff like this, just little utility stuff. They fully seal and enclose their piano hinges. If this hinge was exposed and water got in there, and then it started to freeze, then it would possibly spring the hinge. You ever been at an old campsite and when someone opens their door, it just goes, you know, like screech? Well, it's because that hinge was sprung. You know, they wore it out and they've damaged their hinge because the water could get in there and freeze. You can't have that happen on a Jayco. They just prevent it from happening. Just extra little stuff, like they have rain gutters above the slide outs just to help do anything to channel the water away from those slide seals. Any little extra layer of protection they can. Fully walkable roof decking, that's standard in literally every single Jayco travel trailer. That's why they have the ladder on the back so you can get up there. Things like a spare tire, even the spare tire is a radial. They use Tomax tires, and a lot of people said, well, why'd they quit using Goodyear? These are the exact same price as a Goodyear, and they have a higher load rating. So, you know, you're paying for Goodyear's advertising when you go that route. And these are the same American source product, just, you know, better grade, basically. Now, whenever you see, by the way, this is a quick thing to mention. Stuff like this rear bumper grill mount right here. There are going to be options and upgrades equipped on this trailer that are not standard. Things like your interior color schemes might look different in the pictures from what you see in this video. Don't have a heart attack or anything. This video is here just to kind of tell you about a Whitehawk and show you what a 23MBH can look like. Not necessarily designed to say, here is your 23MBH. Always check your pictures and never hesitate to call our sales staff to make sure. Now, one thing I love to point out is the fact that this little trailer has two entry doors. That is very uncommon in small travel trailers. And they do that because you have a refrigerator, bunks, and a bathroom all right here in the back of the trailer. Those three things are the reason the kids are in and out all day. So they're gonna run around, they're gonna get dirty, they're gonna track dirt in and out of your camper. But now they don't have to track dirt through your whole camper because you have a rear entry door here. You also have a pretty good sized power awning on this thing. It's about 18 feet, plenty enough to put a big picnic table out here right under your outside speakers that connect to the stereo inside. Another of the upgrades that we've put on this one is the enclosed underbelly as part of the Glacier package. And just an interesting note, the underbelly enclosure actually attaches on top of the frame rails. It's not bolted to the bottom of them. The reason I think that's important is, like, if you consider this line right here your frame rail, over time, if it's your underbelly enclosure is bolted to the bottom, it can start to sag and bow. Well, just like you see here, if it creates a gap, then it's not enclosed anymore. It's not doing its job. It's just kind of covered, and that's not the same thing. hop inside here for you. By the way, this trailer, 5,100 pounds. To get this kind of sleeping capacity and living room space in a non-Murphy bed floor plan like this one, it'd have to probably be at least 8 foot longer and several thousand pounds heavier. And that's kind of the very cool part of this floor plan, is it's two floor plans in one. You have a nice living room here like you see right now, but you also have a front bedroom that you can't see yet, and we'll get there in just a second. Another thing to talk about, 23-foot lightweight trailer, and we have central air. That is extremely uncommon in lightweight trailers. There are some manufacturers that will do some of the things I'm showing you in this video, but very few, if any, that do everything I'm showing you here. Things like LED lights standard in your interior. You're going to get that in, I think, all of Jayco's travel trailers now. You don't have to spend time at the shop replacing incandescent bulbs that go out on you. Now, another thing that really separates these from virtually all other lightweights, with very few exception, is the fact that this has 81-inch interior heights. It is taller inside, and that is going to give you more headroom in the shower, in the bunks, in the cabinets. It makes a big difference. It also means taller slide-outs so big goofs like me don't bash their head all the time. Now, we have the king dinette here. That can fold down into about a 7-foot sleeper, and there is storage all the way under it. But notice, too, this table here is freestanding. If you want to kick this table down, you can use it, say, like a coffee table over here. You can use it like a picnic table. Do whatever you want with it. And massive windows overlooking your dinette. And that does open. All the windows in this do open for ventilation. That's one thing I like about these. I was talking about your front area up here. Couple things. First of all, this box you see down here, this is your television. That is an option that we include with basically all of our White Hawks. We have Jayco ship it loose in the box, so you're the first people to touch it and take it home. Real quick, the color scheme we're looking at here is called coffee, but again, that can change depending on the trailer you're looking at. Always make sure the pictures look the way you want them to look, because we try to make those line up. So you have a normal front sofa here that can jackknife down into a sleeper, but that's really not what you're going to use it for. Here's how easy this is to work. I only have one hand to do this. You simply jackknife the sofa down, kind of like you see here. Pull down the bed, and that is it. So now we've gone from a front living room to a front bedroom with a full walk-around queen bed, still complete with his and hers wardrobe closets. So you get a front living room and a front bedroom. If you were to try to build a front bedroom onto the front of this floor plan, because there are floor plans that exist like that, the trailer would have to be at least 10 foot longer. It'd go from a 23-footer to a 33-footer, and suddenly you'd go from 5,100 pounds to about 6,300 pounds, not to mention the fact that you have to pay for all that additional construction. So this Murphy bed keeps your weight down, it keeps your length in check, and it keeps your cost in check. That's why this is so cool. It serves two purposes in one. For very few people actually spend time in the bedroom during the day. So why are you paying for that space that you don't get to use? That's the cool part about a Murphy bed floor plan. You don't have to. I love modern little updates like this. Hold on. Not getting good light down here. Let me shed some light on the subject. There we go. So you see that we have USB plugs down here as well as normal household power outlets. So you do have ways to keep any device charged, you know, like phones, cameras, tablets, just computers or alarm clocks or CPAP machines. You can get power to anything in here. Spinning around just the opposite look of the dinette, and you get to see that's right next to your entertainment center here. Again, the TV with the wall mount is included with the television option that we put in almost every White Hawk. Please always double check, but I can't think of one we've ever brought in without the television. Now down here, your stereo system is also a DVD player. It is also Bluetooth enabled. It basically does everything. You can even use it as an alarm clock now that I think about it. Your overhead cabinetry here in the kitchen is actually pretty generous, and I love the three-dimensional nature of it. They give it some really nice shape and character. But one thing I wanted to show you, this is the spare tire cover that comes with this trailer. I have it folded in quarters so that you kind of get an idea of the size of this cabinet. Look how big that is. It dwarfs that spare tire cover right here. Quick thing to mention, with the power awning, the reason I like it is because if you wake up at night and it's just raining like a son of a gun, you walk over here, you push the in button, 30 seconds later, You go back to bed. You never go outside. You never get wet. You never get beat up by the wind. You just roll the awning up, go back to bed. You may not even wake up the grandkids in the back. Your water heater here, cool thing about this, not only can you control it right here, both on gas and electric, but you can run both simultaneously in this camper for up to 18 gallons of hot water per hour. So what I do, I leave the electric on mine all the time because I go camping too. I don't just talk about these things all day. I leave the electric on all the time to maintain temperature. Then if two or three of us are going to take showers back to back, I'll kick on the gas to give it that extra fast recharge, kick the gas off when I'm done so I'm not burning up my propane. I mean, there's so many more options and features that go into this than the majority of other lightweights can even dream of offering. For instance, this has standard an 8-cubic-foot refrigerator and freezer. I don't know of any other ultralight that even offers an 8-cubic-foot upgrade in this class. I mean, I don't know of any other floor plan where you can get that large of a refrigerator. It's 33% bigger. That means you are not going to spend time at the grocery store restocking. You're going to spend time on your campsite with your family where you are supposed to be. Back here in the rear bunks, and what I love about these is, even if you're not going to camp with people all the time like grandpa and grandma, you know, if the grandkids only come a couple times a year, this floor plan is still awesome because you still have lots of storage back here and the bunks don't take up a lot of space. Heck, you can barely even see the bunks because they wrap around the rear bathroom here. So, you know, you don't have to necessarily worry about, well, I'm paying for something I'm not using. It's not a big deal. You can always throw your bags and totes and stuff up here, and each kid gets a nightlight, LED nightlight at that. Your master bed up front and your bunks are all Denver Mattress brand. That's a residential name. It's far and away better quality stuff than you get in basically any other bunkhouse. And notice your construction on these. It is all plywood box constructed. Your door fronts are hardwood. Everything is made to last here. Right next to the refrigerator, right next to the back door, right next to the bunks is the extra little sink so you can tell the kids to get cleaned up and get ready for dinner. They don't have to track dirt all the way through your camper. And the other thing I like is, even though you can still walk around the front bed to get out the front door, if you don't want to, if you wake up and you don't necessarily want to slide past the person who's sleeping up front, you still have a second door you can enter and exit from. And pretty simple but effective bathroom. What I do like is how they left plenty of extra room around the stool. So, you're not necessarily going to feel like you're cramped in a little closet here. And you do have an extra tall shower, again, because this is 81 inches tall, not 78 like most lightweights. I've actually seen some that are coming in shorter now. Give us a call and learn even more, 800-256-5196. Halet RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Thank you, everybody. Take care. Stay safe. Happy camping.